In this tutorial, we will create a vertical social story graphic for Instagram in Photoshop and practice using the type tool. To get started, I already have a photo open of a surfer. Next, I need to create my artboard. Let's go to File, New. I'm going to use a mobile preset today, so I'm going to click over to the mobile presets, view all presets. There's a preset for 1080 by 1920 pixels. We'll select that one. All of my specs appear over here on the right. And let's just go ahead and click create. So before we do anything, I like to go ahead and save my graphic to my computer. So go to File, Save As. The first thing we need to do is put this surfing photo into our artboard. So I'm navigating to my surfing.jpg open image, and using the Move tool in our toolbar, I'm going to click into the image, click and hold, continue to hold on my cursor, and you're going to drag up to your graphic artboard, and then release your mouse, and it drops the photo onto your artboard. This is obviously too big, it's the wrong size. So we need to resize it and make it smaller to fit the artboard. I'm going to zoom out so I can see a little bit more of the artboard on the side. You can do that by using the zoom tool on the left toolbar or command plus and minus on your keyboard on a Mac. Let's go to Edit, Transform, Scale. I want to scale this image so that the surfer in this photo is on the bottom third of our graphic. So we want to put text on the top of this. So somewhere around here is perfect. Let's get started adding text. Using the text tool in your toolbar on the left, I'm going to just click into my artboard with the text tool, and it should populate some text for you, often lorem ipsum. If for some reason it didn't, click into your artboard with the text tool and start typing. You should see some words appear. If you still don't see words appear, it might be because your text size is too large. You can try adjusting that. So this made some lorem ipsum for me. I'm gonna move it around with the move tool. So I just clicked and dragged it. The words we're gonna use for the headline are surf clinic. So I'm going to click and select my text and type surf clinic. Let's next adjust this font and the text color. This little text editing box appears for me, but I don't really like this. It doesn't show me everything I need to see. So I like to use my character panel. Go to Window, Character, and you'll see lots of font adjustment options pop up in this character panel. Let's change the font here. I have installed an Adobe font called Cheddar Gothic Rough that I am going to use for this project. And I want this font to fill the space really nicely. So 100 pixels is too small. You can click on the drop-down menu to make it larger. Let's go really large. That's a little bit too much. Let's go to 50. That's about right. And if you move your cursor right and left, you can adjust the font size this way too. Let's brighten this up by changing the color. Using the text tool again, I'm going to select the text, and in my character panel, there's a color box. If I click on that, I get this color picker that pops up. I want to look for kind of a lime green, a bright yellow. That makes me think of surfing, makes me think of being out in the sun, so I think that would complement my design well. Use this rainbow box to kind of drag around and find a color that I like. You can adjust the hue of that color. Okay, I think that feels pretty nice, and I have nice contrast. I can see the text really well. Next, let's add some details about our event, the surf clinic. I'm going to click the type tool again, and this time I'm going to click and drag a small box. It's filling it with lorem ipsum, and it's using the same font styles that I set up for my headline, which is not what we want. Something like Arial or Avenir. And make this text much smaller. So I'm going to drag this way down. So the details we're going to put in are the location and the date of our event. don't think this should be, this detail text should be the same color as our headline. This color doesn't work as well in small text. So I need to use something that's got even more contrast. So going back to my character panel, I'm going to use this box again and just drag it all the way to the white. So we have white detail text. Can also adjust the font weight. Currently it's on Avenir Roman. Might want something a little thicker, like medium black, and just see how that feels. The alignment that I have on this text, you can click over to the paragraph tab or go to window paragraph. This is currently centered, and I think that looks pretty nice. I'm going to have this text tucked right under this headline. I'm going to move it just a hair. If you need to adjust leading, you'd want to select your text and you can adjust how far away these lines are from one another. Next, we're going to add one more block of text. So select the type tool again. I'm going to click and drag a larger box this time. We're going to add some lorem ipsum and even more details about this event. So again, it populated this text box with centered type that's the same style as the text above it. I'm going to make this even smaller. We want this text to recede even more. I don't need it to be bold. I want it to be maybe kind of a regular font. We don't need this many lines. Let's go with 3 or 4 lines. And I'm also going to reduce the leading on this just a little bit. Okay, so the very last step in this design is we're actually going to add a cool texture on top of our graphic. So I'm going to navigate on my computer. I have this, it's a halftone dot texture, and I'm just going to click and drag this into my artboard. It is a horizontal image. I need to make this bigger and make it match my space. And I'm actually going to rotate it as well. Let's go look at our layers so we can see what's going on. This is on top of our text layers and our image. And that's great. That's what I want. But obviously I want to see what's underneath it. We're going to use these what's called blending modes. These are really cool and it's a great way to add subtle textures and add some transparency. With this halftone layer selected, I'm just going to test out a few of these blending modes. I often use multiply. You can kind of scroll through here and see the different effects that it does to your image. I'm also going to bump the opacity of this texture down just a little bit. I just want like a hint of the texture on top. It's currently on top of my type. I think that's a little much. So I'm going to drag that layer just to be above my photo. So the type is super readable, but it's really just evident in the top of this photo and in the surfer graphic. So this social media post is ready to go. You can go to File, Save. So we've saved our original file. And then last step is to go File, Save a Copy. I'm going to save this on my computer. And I'm going to save probably a JPEG or a PNG to upload to my social media channels. So that's how you create a vertical social media graphic. Follow Crye Studio for more Photoshop tutorials. Thanks so much.